The bandstands were built as a centrepiece of these great Victorian municipal parks, and both often physically the centrepiece, but often the centre of attention. So, you know, they had the military bands playing there, or, you know, they were focal points, really. And now these objects have remained there. So to me, not exactly the guardians, but they're what somebody described as these noble sentinels. You know, they've watched all of this change happen. They've watched the Edwardian ladies with their parasols potter up and down. They've watched punks in the 1970s hang out. They've watched, you know, teenagers drinking cider and under their eaves, all of that kind of stuff. They've watched all of this, all of these things happen. The images are made up of as a photograph of each face of the bandstand. Mostly they're octagonal, so it's 8 photographs. So taken dead on, looking straight through the symmetrical sides. Those 8 photographs are then layered together, and because the bandstands are symmetrical, when you layer the images together, the bandstand registers as a coherent object, whereas the background becomes this melee of all of the different backgrounds, all combined together. So hence why the bandstand stands out from, you know, and you get this kind of painterly effect around the background. And so to me, what's interesting about the end result of the images is there's, because through the layering and through this slightly wistful nature of them, there's a kind of a sense of history. And the figures that you see in them, although they're all contemporary figures, they could almost be Edwardian ladies with parasols.